How does it feel to be at the first one of these big fan events where you can talk really openly about being Black Canary and how that is? Because obviously, you've had a couple of interviews, but this is kind of...
Right. No, absolutely. It's freaking amazing. Like, finally, I can say it. I mean, it's completely fulfilling, and this character, this job, this role, this, you know, series has been a dream come true, and I really wanted to do that action and movie in this genre, so I couldn't be happier.
Are you working out every minute of every day?
Oh, every minute of every day? No. I've been working out a lot and really, really hard, but I think it's cool because it makes it that much more realistic and believable. It also feels good to be in good shape and to know that I can kick anybody's ass. I try and do as much as I possibly can. There are, obviously, there's insurance involved at some point where, you know, I shouldn't be jumping off rooftops, which is fun by me. But as far as physically and the fighting, I do as much as I can and as much as they let me. And I've been in martial arts training with Thomas. Instagram, I post about it.
Was it a relief to finally be part of all aspects of the show?
Yes, you have no idea. It was a long time coming, but I think it was great. Thanks to the writers who wrote really well for me, and it was more believable. And as an actor, it was amazing because, you know, I wasn't season two of the Black Canary overnight, you know? I had to go through hardship, and it made it that much more believable and realistic, and I was just doing what they were writing, and it was that much more helpful for when I finally became Black Canary. It was, like, all legitimate, if that makes sense. You know what I'm saying? It felt more realistic.
What can you tell us about Laurel's arc this season, where she begins starting?
We'll definitely see Laurel a lot more polished and good at, you know, being a quote-unquote superhero. She's obviously, last season she was a fighter, she's always been a fighter, but it was a lot more heart. And this season I think that it's not just heart, she actually has been training and working, you know, that aspect of herself and her superhero going out at night. And it's also been like a big role to take on along with Felicity and Dibble, to take Oliver's position basically. And whether or not they're capable of doing that, you'll have to wait to watch season 4. But I definitely think Laurel will have a big part on the influence of creating legends. Sorry, I have to be careful how I worded that.
Yeah,
I was like, what can I tell you? But she does. She plays a big part in that. And I think you guys will all be surprised.
Are you able to tell us anything about Laurel's awareness of Sarah whenever she factors in?
No, I can't tell you that. No, I really can't tell you that, though. But I think that, you know, if Sarah got to see Laurel right now, I think that she would be proud of her, you know, for all the hard work she's put in. And I also think that she would be worried, probably, because she loves her sister and doesn't want her sister to get hurt. But I think she would definitely be proud. I know I am.
Are you going to miss the female bonding scenes between Laurel and Missy that we had from last season?
Absolutely. I mean, Katrina's awesome, and I love working with her, and hopefully she'll come back. Who knows? It's television, right?
Well, the dynamic would have changed quite a bit, because now Nissa reports to Malcolm Merlyn, so she can't just kind of be her own woman and do her own thing and train more all she wants to.
Right, but it's still television, and anything can happen. And it's right now, that's what she's doing, but I have a feeling there's going to be more to the story.
Going to be in a lot of crossovers with Legends.
I hope so. That would be awesome.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you.